Hello and welcome to another episode of me painting again. I'm going to do this scene from an old painting. It's part of a big painting, but I only chose this boat to do. I've actually painted it before, years ago. I thought I'd do it again, but in a just my way of painting, just not worrying too much, just painting. See, what I used to do is I would worry about it all. How to get the paint to the right colour, how to get the right strokes, and try and copy people exactly where. I don't feel the need to do that anymore, so I'm just going to paint and see what happens. See what goes wrong. So here's my brushes, they're just filbert brushes. They're the Bob Ross filberts. They're really well used, as you can tell. This one has worn away, but it makes a perfect point. You see, these worn brushes. I used to read about it, painters wanting worn out brushes because they work better. And I didn't realise what they were talking about, but you get different shapes and then they become your magic brushes. Anyway, I've not got many paints on the palette. Some burnt umber, ultramarine blue, yellow ochre, burnt sienna, which came out like a bullet when I put it on there. So there's loads on there, more than I wanted, but never mind. Some titanium white. So, first things first, I'm going to start with the water. And I want like a dark bluey brown. Yellow ochre, sort of a dirty dark greenish colour. It's really what it is. Just to get things going. So there's quite a lot of movement in the water. And I'm gonna keep that movement going with some of these. Whether I'll use brush strokes or scrub the paint on, I haven't decided that either. No decisions have really been made. That's what I mean about. Painting now is different to how I used to paint. I think it's because, you know, you just have, you paint so many paintings, then you get a bit of practice, and then you start thinking, well, this is wrong, so we can change that now. You start thinking about it a bit more, and you start doing your own thing, really. Have fun doing this one. I wanted to do this for a while actually. Just chucked a bit of white in my paint. It's a little bit, more blue in it. Making it a little bit more of a blue. It's all dull, dirty colours at the moment, really. My reference just fell down. I'm just going to stick it back up. It was a little bit too little masking tape on it. I only had one little strip. Sometimes that's all you need, one strip. Yeah, I've got the old painting underneath, just so I've got a look, something to look at that I can modify if needed. bit more white in my colour for this area. Keep pulling my head back to have a look at what I'm doing. I'm just creating a bit more dark because I lost it. That's my dark colour. So I'm using my camera from the other side now because seem to be able to get away with it. Ooh. I didn't used to because the light would reflect. It would reflect terribly on the canvas, and it was a bit of a nightmare. But it seems to be all right at the moment. It's because it's quite light outside. So I'm not using any fake lights. I'm just using the sun, and there is a little light on, but it's just in case that the light outside goes. I've got a little bit of a light on, but it's not a very heavy, not a strong bulb or anything. Only a small one. Yeah, so I gessoed this canvas to start it off with a nice bit of grey gesso, quite dark grey. I used black acrylic and I threw that into my gesso to make it this colour. It worked nicely. A little boat there. I didn't actually paint that boat in the first time that I painted this. Because what I used to do, people used to think all I did was paint Bob Ross stuff, but I was painting this sort of stuff as well. It's just I didn't film myself because it used to take me a week. That's the thing. You don't realise how long it takes. Especially when you're a novice or a beginner like me. Probably not quite a beginner anymore, but back then I was like a total beginner. I consider myself an expert now. Well, you might as well go the whole hog. I'm a master. No, I don't think I'm a master painter. I don't do it enough. You need to be painting all the time, full time, to be a master, wouldn't you? Unfortunately, I have to go and do a job. So, not quite a master. Although I know some of the old guys, old painters, they used to have jobs as well, didn't they? In the day, years and years ago, hundreds of years ago. I think we assume that they all were just full-time painters, but it's just not the case. quite a lot of movement in there, which is quite nice. Just sort of sit back and have a look at the painting. Can use your finger if you want to smudge anything, or maybe you want to paint it with finger. It doesn't really matter. Gone a little bit lighter on this because I want to bring that out. I remember once thinking, quite a long time ago, I was like, oh, I'll paint this, because I've done a practice go, it only took me 4 weeks. So I can paint it again, and probably get it done in no time for YouTube. And I just kept thinking, nah, it's not happening. Because other paintings I was doing were taking so much time, and I didn't want to do long episodes. But I'm not fussed now. If this takes me a couple of weeks, I'll just keep filming myself. Just having fun with it really now. Just sitting back, having a look. Do with a light. I'm getting a light colour. I need to have some light round here and there. We'll paint those figures back in. There's a couple of people on the boat there. We can paint that back in, no problem. We just need this light. Oh, not quite there. Use this to get rid of that a bit. Just a bit of dry material. Got all that spray. Got that mist in a bit. Got it coming up here as well. Start that off. Covered the whole canvas at that part anyway. Now we can start working on the sky. and then we can start bringing stuff back. Start bringing stuff out, I should say, in the water. But we need the sky going. We need the sky. It's sort of a... It's kind of yellow ochre-y. Maybe a little bit greeny brown. I think it was a power latch over. Just a bit lighter. Sort of we'll go with this anyway. See what it looks like. It's quite nice actually. You'll notice this painting, I'm going with a different technique that I did on the last one. This one I'm more scrubbing paint rather than plonking it, splodging it on, I guess. But it's okay. What it does is it makes it easier for us to do it this way. We have a bit more of a chance to mess up. It's always good to be able to mess up and not worry when you're painting, giving yourself that opportunity. Back having a look. Just making a bigger pile of this colour. Just switch there, put a little bit more blue in it, a bit more to paint that on the top as well. Get rid of that. Just so we know where it is, I'll leave that bit. Using my lefty a bit. My right tires out. We've got clouds as well, we've got to think about. Smudge them while we're doing this. Not worried about the sky being the same, I'm just going to get the basics on it. Like I said, it's not an exact copy of that. just using that was the idea. Sit back again, have a look. Just so we know where this is, I'll leave an area. More light. I don't mind some of the darkness of the canvas pops out. I didn't mind that really. So we need a bit more colour at the top. Go a little bit darker, a bit more blue and brown in there. Bit blue and brown. Okay, got nice light coming off this cloud. Pull it across here. Bit of a yellowy colour in that as well. Something like that, and then bring a bit in here. Okay, something like that will get us started a bit. Soften that area. Okay. Okay, so I went for a drink and then come back again. And you gotta have that relaxing time when you're painting. Now I'm gonna start working on this area. Different colour. I think I might go a bit darker. I get the dark in first, then I can play around a bit with the light. Just get that colour right there. A bit more blue in this, a bit too yellow down there. Something like that. That's quite nice. About there, and then I can start putting a bit more light on this, and I want to get the posts. So I'm going to get a bit of blue and brown. I use my old brush. Blue and brown, and there's a bit of yellow ochre in there as well, actually. So I want to start something like that. Use a bit of that colour just to strain it up a little bit. I've actually got it a bit too wide down there. That wants to be a bit more. And it's kind of dirty, weak, burnt sienna there on this one. Something like that. Bring this back over it. Got a little bit of blue and brown. I don't want to get this area here quite dark. There's some stuff in there. There's something there. Piece of wood there. This needs to be a bit more. Like that. And then we can start adding a bit of light on the side of the boat. A bit of light, just get that light in there. And if you can paint light, you can paint dark when needed. And just go in between each and try your best. That's what I think. Try your best, see if you can get it all looking all right. And that's all you can do, really, isn't it? Do your best. I'll do for that now, I think. Well, I could paint that person in this gap here. The reason I like old paintings, they're always very well designed. That's one thing for sure. They're always very well designed. Because they, what they've done is they've used a mist to be able to light up these two characters here. I'll use a little bit of white and burnt sienna just to make a light. Maybe I need to be a bit lighter actually. For the skin of this guy there. Get that light there. That's not bad actually. I don't need to go too crazy with the detail on the people. I mean, that's something you could do if you leave it to dry and then do a bit more. I don't want to do this over a lot of time really. This is going to all be painted in this video. There's a bloke there. Bit of light. It's very loosely painted. Get the basic idea of somebody there. So, I think next bit, I'm using my dirty old rag to sort of wipe the brushes a sec, and then we can do a bit more. I think I want to get the light on the side of this here. So you could do that in many ways really. You could use a knife and get the line of light. Sort of like, I'll show you actually. You could get the line of light using a knife and sort of the light coming down. Like that works quite good actually. What I might do actually, just cutting across, getting a little roll of paint, I might do that bit as well. while we're at it. So I've just mixed up, I'll show you it. Just mixed up with a knife, a bit of a colour. That's all blue in it. That's dull colour. Couldn't cut across. Get the paint. Get a nice bit of paint, and I can go along here. And I can make it dark, and I can use the same. Go down there. That works quite nice, doesn't it? Works pretty good. So I'll go with that. I could even use this knife to do could have that going about here. There's one all the way, coming all the way around, that's a bit. So you're about there. There's this one up there as well. It goes on the top of that. Goes to about there. Like that. There's one down the back. Back there. And there's some rigging in front of this as well. I'm not going to go too crazy with the rigging, to be honest. I'm going to go back to that sail. Get some light on this sail. Some white yellow ochre. Start building it up. building this up a bit. Got like a second light. Almost a second light, I should say. Well, it's got a nice shape now. More of the white. Start pulling this wave material. Sitting back having a look at that. Oops. Don't want this quite as dark as that. Get a bit of light in that. Sit back, have a look. Quite nice. So I've got that going. Just want to put a few little splotches of brown on the ribbon bit. Use a smaller brush. I just want the here and here. And there's some that goes along there, but there. One that goes. So we need a knife again to do that. Just cut in a little bit of paint and probably got a bit too much there. Some areas you can use light instead. Actually, I might use this brush. While I'm at it, I can add a bit more light there. More there. A bit more rigging there. You can even use light to do your rigging as well, if you wanted to add a bit of light in there. Right, maybe there's a bit of a light on those. Bit of light there. We'll go with that, I quite like that. Might need to bring him out a bit more. He's a bit low actually. And this guy here, I'll bring him about there instead. Put the colour on his back. And very see how sometimes you get that nice stroke, and that would probably be enough. Like he's got funny hair. To put the face back in, that's better. So you need to use the dark and the light to get someone in there. There we go. He's there, about. Now then, I think what I'll do next, I need a bit more of a nice yellow. I think I'll get a bit of chrome yellow. Just put a little bit of chrome yellow on the palette. I'll give my brush a wipe again. And make it a nice light yellow for this. I can put on nice bit of yellow colour on it. Just want to get this bit here, it sort of goes. Yeah, it's quite nice. There we go, something like that. I think I'll leave it at that. I want a bit more light using a little bit of yellow and white again. And this bit there. So you get the paint right on the edge of your brush. Is what I do. When you start going into quite a lot of paint now, you go into the edge of your brush so you can then just sort of place it. I think that's quite nice. I'm quite liking that. Now what I'm going to do is start working a bit more on the water. Just splash that water up there. Splashing up here. And up there, it's going up here. There is actually spray marks behind there as well. See if I can get that. Can just tap that away a little bit. see, we've got water splashing. And down. Waves splashing there. And I think a few more these pieces on there. I like it actually, you know, when you start doing these really thick bits, you're just sort of piling it on. I do like it. It's something that you don't get to do with other paints really. You can't pile it on like this. I think that's looking pretty nice actually. I don't want to do too much more because at the moment my eye goes to the boat and the splash of the boat, which is what I want. Let's put where the flag is as well. A bit about there, wasn't it? Nice little bit of colour. Yeah, I might, while I'm at it, got a few boats in the background, haven't we? That we haven't done. The one there. Better. I didn't really like the way that was. See how you can do a bit of finger painting though. And bring that out a bit more. Just put in a few I'll do. I'm not going to go too much into detail for that one because it's quite far away, isn't it? And this one's even further. This one back here. I'll just do a little might even just leave it at that. Yeah, I'm quite liking this. Maybe I'll put a little bit of a sail on that. Let's sit back, have a look. Sitting back, having a look. And what I need to do is bring this together. Movement coming along here as well. Let's have a look at that. I didn't need it there. And there. Flipping that. There we go. Yeah, I think I'll go with that. I think I will go with it. Maybe a few. Yeah, I think I'll go with that there. I've enjoyed that. I hope you've enjoyed watching. I hope it gives you an idea that you could do something similar, better, probably. So I'll say, I don't know if you're thinking the same as me, but I haven't put a little bird in it. It's always nice to put a little bird in, isn't it? So what I might do is put a little bird. Say if I was a little bird, I'd be flying there. Just an indication of a bird there. But yeah, I do really like this. It's got a lot of energy, a lot more movement than my first attempt at this, and also I've done another version of it before in my sketchbook painting book. I painted it. There's another version of it in there. It's one of those that I'll probably keep coming back to and trying to paint. But I've enjoyed this one a lot more. A lot of paint on there, quite thick, and yeah, good fun to do. So thanks very much for watching this one, and I'll see you in another one. Cheers, bye.